Hello everyone, this is me Mahatma Raj and I am currently a University of London LLB Honours second year student. In this video, I will be solving a question for European Union law for the topic free movement of goods. So this is the statement of the question. I want you to stop the video right here and read the question on your own. So there is this one issue that surrounds all the points where the laws are applicable. So the issue is Bulgarian law and the BCCA assessment. The second is Bulgarian Mayer, which is an MEQR as per decennial and a discriminatory Mayer. Then comes Article 34 TFEU, which prohibits MEQR for imports. And then Article 36, which provides the ground for derogation from Article 34. An example given here is public policy. And then comes the selling arrangements under CEC and the further development of case laws under Italian MOPADs and Mikkelsen. Issue number one is Bulgarian law and BCC assessment. Government has adopted this measure to reduce screen time for children. This part is more relevant to the part B of the question. So here are the rules for issue number 2, 3 and 4 as they are interlinked. First, we have to see whether the Bulgarian law, the Bulgarian Mayer, is an MEQR or not. For that, we will look up the decennial definition of MEQR. MEQRs or Mayer equivalent to quantitative restrictions are trading rules enacted by member states that are capable of hindering directly or indirectly trade between European Union member states. Article 34 then prohibits imposing MEQRs on imports, and another relevant rule is the derogation grounds from Article 36. So the applicable ground from Article 36 here is public policy ground, and an example of adoption of public policy ground can be seen from the case law Koenigsegg Limited. Using these laws, you will write that Bulgarian law is an MEQR as it is hindering directly the trade between European Union member states. Then you can use Article 34 to state that it is prohibited, and then come on to the Article 36 that the derogation ground of public policy is applicable here, and state the case law Koenigsegg Limited and say that Bulgaria can use the public policy ground to derogate from Article 34. Now moving to issue number 5, which is regarding CEC selling arrangements. The selling arrangements under CEC are legal and beyond the scope of Article 34. But the recent case laws following CEC, for example KO versus Government International Products, say that an impeding the market access test should rather be used. This has been followed in Italian MOPADs and Mikkelsen. Now we'll have to see whether the Bulgarian law impedes the market access for Tony's DVDs, and whether can it be justified on grounds of public policy. Coming to the first part of this question, Bulgarian law does impede the market access. Now, whether it can be justified on grounds of public policy or not, the discretion for this lies with the court. Now coming to the proportionality test, the approach to which is, can the objective be achieved by a measure that is less of an interference? Applying this to the situation, the Bulgarian government could have used a measure that was less of an interference with the trade. Now coming to the conclusion, the Bulgarian measure might be held disproportionate, though you may even argue otherwise, as court give due weightage to public policy matters and often decide in favor of the state. I think Tony cannot challenge the blockage of his consignment, as it is a state measure in respect of a public policy matter, and that too concerning children. You can give reference to a case law, Dynamic Median, where the court applied a soft proportionality test for grounds of child protection. Thus, Tony cannot do anything either about the blockage or selling DVDs to the shops. I hope the video was helpful. If you think it was, please let me know in the comments below so that I keep on uploading similar videos.